Family and friends, kindly take your seat. You will return to your loved one after the eulogy.
Bonjour, Frère FC. Est-ce que vous attendez? Kindly take your seat. You will return to your loved one because we need to have the eulogy to begin with. We see so many of you just standing. There's no need for that. You will return to your loved one.
To visit his daughter Laurentia with his sack of food, sometimes waiting outside the store. As soon as we reach, he would start saying, "Parents, dis-moi la qu'est-ce que c'est jamais." Which is us. As his only daughter, Laurentia, we was his second best. He loved us all, treating us like we was his children too. But in all, he has his favorite. Pinky, he would ask, "Kote shabin moya?" So, Daddy, may you rest in peace. He will also ask Sean, "Uhakade pusha bin moya?" But he will surely miss Tine, Daddy, as we call him. May you rest in peace. In perfect peace, Daddy, we all miss you.
Thank you. your loved one for reception of the body. Please stand.
Let's all be quiet, please. Let's be quiet. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and with your spirit. I bless the body of Joseph Symphorien with the holy water. That recalls of his baptism, of which St. Paul writes, all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we are buried together with him. So that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. On the day of his baptism, Joseph Symphorien put on Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, may he be clothed in glory. Paul Bearers.
Let us all join in singing our entrance hymn, Carry Your Candle.
There is a candle in every soul.
Carry your candle
My dear brothers and sisters, we have come together to renew our trust in Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death, and by rising has opened for us the gates of heaven. So let us pray for our brother Joseph Symphorien, that he may share in Christ's victory. And let us pray for ourselves, that the Lord may grant us the gift of his loving consolation. Let us pray. God of loving kindness, listen favorably to our prayers. Strengthen our belief that your Son has risen from the dead, and our hope that your servant Joseph will also rise again. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Please be seated. The two persons doing the reading, please come up. The first reading is taken from the Apocalypse, chapter 21, verse 1 to 7.
John saw a new heaven and a new earth. The first heaven and the first earth had disappeared now, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city and the new Jerusalem coming down from God out of heaven, as beautiful as a bride, all dressed for her husband. Then I heard a loud voice call from the throne. You see this city? Here God lives among men. He will make his home among them. They shall be his people, and he will be their God. His name is God with them. He will wipe away all tears from their eyes. There will be no more death, and no more mourning or sadness. The world of the past has gone. Then the one sitting on the throne spoke. Now, I am making the whole of creation new, he said. I will give water from the well of life, free to anybody who is thirsty. It is the rightful inheritance of the one who proves victorious, and I will be his God, and he a son to me. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
In response to the first reading, we'll all join in singing, Do Not Be Afraid.
When you
walk through the waters, I'll be with you. You have never seen beneath the waves. Do not be afraid, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. Fire is burning all around you. You will never be consumed by the flames. Do not be afraid, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. When the fear of loneliness is looming, then remember I am at your side. Do not be afraid, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. When you dwell in the exile of the stranger, remember you are precious in my eyes. Do not be afraid, for I have redeemed. For I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine.
The second reading is from Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 to 18.
We want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. He can tell you from the Lord's own teaching that any of us who have left alive until the Lord's coming will not have any advantage over those who have died. At the trumpet of God, the voice of the archangel will call out to command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise, and then those of us who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
God loved the world so much that he gave his only Son. Everyone who believes in him has eternal life.
Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the Jews, I tell you most solemnly, whoever listens to my word and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life. Without being brought to judgment, he has passed from death to life. I tell you most solemnly, the hour will come, in fact, it is here already, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and all who hear it will live. For the Father, who has the source of life, has made the Son the source of life. And because he is the Son of Man, has appointed him supreme judge, do not be surprised at this, for hour is coming, when the dead will leave their graves at the sound of his voice. Those who did good will rise again to life, and those who did evil to condemnation. I can do nothing by myself. I can only judge as I am told to judge. And my judging is just, because my aim is to do not my own will, but the will of him who sent me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, to the Symphorien family and all who have known our brother Joseph, for all of you who have come to sympathize with the family in the passing of our brother, to every one of you, a heartfelt condolence on behalf of our parish. We have gathered together to give thanks to God for the gift of life the Lord blessed our brother with. He enjoyed, cherished 86 years of life here on earth, a ripe old age, a long life God has blessed with. As we are here recollecting and remembering the good things the Lord has done for our brother, and shall be grateful to God for his good deeds, as today's the readings, the first reading, a new heaven and a new earth in the book of Revelation or Apocalypse tells that everyone who die in the new heaven and a new earth is they are going to be with God and God is going to be with them. And that is a promise of the death of this earthly life coming to an end. Everyone who lives this earthly life, when comes to an end, we all have to be living this earthly life and have to look forward to a new heaven. Did not we hear sometimes when people say, when good things come on our lives here on earth, we say, I find heaven on earth. Because things are good, things are nice. Sometimes don't we say, when things find very hard in life, then we say, oh my God, I'm experiencing misery and hell here on earth. Now, the reading tells us today, a new heaven and a new earth. And this is what is eternity, everlasting life. And this is what today, the second reading as well, St. Paul, first letter to Thessalonians, tells us. There isn't any advantage of those who have died and gone and those who are alive. Because we all will be judged according to our deeds and what we have done. Either we die and go before, or we live to die yet in the future. Anybody who is left behind, we are not here to live long. We are only here to prepare our way when we bid farewell to our dear ones, those who go before us. There is nothing mandatory that only those who are aging have to go before. Sometimes those who are not aged, young, also go before us. So there isn't a discrimination, there isn't a plan that who has to go first and who has to go later. No. It's all in the plan of God. For our brother, what God has blessed for 86 years, it is the plan of God. And it is God's doing. And therefore we all will be standing in front of the judgment seat of God. Dear brothers and sisters, every funeral celebration we participate is a time for us to reflect on our own lives here on earth. And sometime it is good for us as well to put our lives right, the time that is given to us. Although we grieve the passing and we have come to do a decent Christian burial for our brother, and it's also good for us, our own selves, to think of our own lives. Because there isn't any advantage of those who have died and those who are alive. A little advantage we have is we can put our lives right. Put things right with God and with our brothers and sisters. You know how stubborn we are? How hard-headed we are. We know very well when we die, we go with nothing. We are so hard, although we know we are not going to go with anything, we are too selfish. We want everything for us. We want everything for us. Certainly, we are not going to go with it, but we don't remember that. I want everything for myself. We begin to be selfish. We're sure we are going to go without anybody with us. At the same time, you know how cruel sometimes we become? We ill-treat the other. We sometimes don't talk to our own siblings with grudges and vengeance we harbor in our hearts. At every funeral we come, by the time somebody dies, we all cry. Is that cry true? Is it a crocodile cry? We need to think a lot. We know we are all going to leave, and we are going to leave everything and go. But you know, we fight a lot here on earth. For what? For possessions, for properties. Our parents are aging. We fight. We are 5 siblings or 8 siblings, and we refuse to take a proper care for our aging parents. Who will take care? Who will provide what? How much will you provide? How much money are you going to give? We are rationing our produce to care. At the end of the day, all 8 siblings want equal share of the property left behind by the parents. What judgment is that? I'm not talking about Joseph Symphorien. I'm not talking about that family. Absolutely. I'm bringing out a point that which we don't seem to be thinking in our lives. You know, we are so stubborn. We are so hard-headed people, you know. We know God is all-powerful. We know God is all-authoritative. At the same time, we don't seem to be bowing down to God. We each one want to be a God.
We think we are powerful unless when we are struck. And when we are going to our sick bed and the doctor tells us, well, I don't know how long you will live, but until you die, you will have to stay in your sick bed. Other than before that, we felt we have all power. Look at the greeting tells us, I tell you solemnly, whoever listens to my words and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life. Whoever listens to me and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life. My dear brothers and sisters, some of you sitting here, I know you all from Fosenjac. I know some of you say you are Catholics, some say you are not Catholics. But some of these faces I have never seen in church in Fosenjac. We call ourselves Catholic. Some of you are smiling. Yes. I come to church every Sunday. I see some faces are in church every Sunday. We have to listen to the word of God. Invariably, all of you, most of you sitting here are from Fosenjac. I know people from Soufriere who are here. And I know people from Fosenjac who are coming to church. I see their faces sitting here. Why? Why don't we want to be going to church and praying? You see how hard we are. We know God is powerful. We know God is all doing. We know God is in control. We know God's plan is the best, a better plan for us. No other plans. But in spite of all that, we refuse. Moi pakale lamesh dimash. Moi las. Moi ni tuawai. This is what we say. We have to go to church. Moi las. I have been at work for a whole week. How can we demand things like that? We come to celebrate our brother's life, 86 years, long life. And I was told, I did not know about our brother. I was told he was playing in a band, music. And he used to go to church off and on. And he was a faithful Catholic. The children of Joseph Symphorien. Although you grieve of your father or your grandfather, take up the legacy. Some grown-ups are going soon. They are grown-ups. They are going soon. They're leaving things behind for us. We have learned something from them and we have refused to learn some things from them. And at last we will be quarreling among ourselves. I have not learned anything from my parents. Some of the traditions, some of the culture, some of the food, some of the planting, some of the agricultures, we will not have it. We will not have it. Then who are we going to blame? Are we going to blame our ancestors? If we keep blaming our ancestors, then we have not learned anything from them. Our grown-ups, our ancestors have left behind a lot of things for us. Faith, culture, tradition, food, agriculture, family, life. They have left behind. Today we have become so self-oriented and modern life. 86 years of life. We need to thank God. And we need to turn to God. And as Jesus says today, unless you believe in the Son of God, unless you believe in His word, you will not have eternal life. If you believe in me, you will have eternal life. Let's hold on. Hold on to God, the giver of life. This earthly life will come to an end. But eternal life, today's first reading tells us, He is with them and they are with God. That is our destination. However we live our lives, however we move about in this life, our destination is God. Either you believe it or not. Our destination is judgment seat of God. Our destination is end time. After saying all this, We come to bury our beloved one, right? We come to bury our beloved one, right? We have come, sing, participate, and celebrate the funeral rites service. And we'll be taking our brother to do a Christian decent burial. And you know, while we go in the procession, you know how much we feel shy to walk in the procession? We people, we run before. We don't want to die, we want to run to the cemetery first. If you want to go to cemetery first, die, you'll go to cemetery first. Why don't we join to sing? We all have the booklets in our hands. Wait and see, after the funeral, these booklets will be lying down on the road. We'll leave it in the bin. When we have this booklet, participate, sing. And this is what is called burying the dead. Burying the dead is not just we put on nice clothes and come and sit in church and run on the wayside, the pavement by the road, reach the cemetery and talk and talk and talk, and then leave the cemetery, eat something, drink something and go back home. It's not the burial. It's not what we come to do. What we come to do is sing, feel sorry, mourn with the family, comfort the family, pray, and do the burial, and go home sad. At the same time, thank God that the Lord has permitted you to do a burial for your loved one. And thank God for the comfort that you have received from the one another. Sad, sometimes we come to the funerals and we don't even see the family members and say my condolence, and we don't even do that. We stand by the end of the church and stand at the gate of the cemetery and eat and stand and drink, and we leave the place. It is not Christian burial. Every deceased member is depending on our service to them. Today is Joseph Symphorien. Tomorrow is you. Today is Joseph Symphorien. Tomorrow is you. What goes around comes around. Well, that's what you sow, that's what you will reap. We have to sow good seeds, and therefore we can reap a good harvest. Lot more in our lives, dear sisters and brothers, we have to learn. We have to learn. Remember, Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. All those who believe in me, even though you die, you will live. If you do not believe in me, you will die. You may not live. If you believe in me, you will die and you will live. Amen?
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May the soul of Joseph Symphorien and the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Please stand. Those with bidding prayers, please come up.
God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
for the church. Almighty God, help our church body in the manner. Almighty God, help our church body to walk in the manner worthy of the call you have given us. Help us in all our interactions with one another to humble and gentle hearts. Grant us patience for one another, bearing with one another in love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord graciously
hear us.
Prayer for the family. Heavenly Father, bless our families with love and protect us from harm. Give us grace to forgive, strength, and overcome the difficulties we face, and keep us together when the world tries to pull us apart. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Prayer for our nation. Heavenly Father, thank you for the blessings of living in this nation. Today we pray for our leaders across the land. We ask for your wisdom and will guide them in all they do. Strengthen each leader with resolve to do what is best for our country. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Prayer for the sick, suffering, and aging. Heavenly Father, giver of life and health, comfort and relieve your sick servants and give your power of healing to those who minister to their needs, that they may be strengthened in your weakness and have confidence in your loving care. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Prayer for the deceased. Almighty Father, you who have commanded us to honor our father and our mothers in your mercy, have pity on the soul of Joseph Symphorien and forgive his trespasses. May he be seen again in the joy of everlasting brightness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, in baptism, you have given the pledge of eternal life for our brother Joseph. And in Holy Communion, he tests and sees how good you are. Lord, today he is not in our midst. We thank you for the gift of life that you have given him, his family. Today, Lord, in your mercy and compassion, grant our brother eternal life in the company of saints and angels. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Please be seated.
Brothers and sisters, we'll now take up a collection, and this collection is for the keep of the cemetery. During this time, we will all join in singing, "What a Friend We Have in Jesus." Can we have 3 more volunteers, please?
What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry
Jesus knows us.
if you're still our refuge. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Though thy friends despise for safety, take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms we'll take and shield. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often
We will now have the signing of the register. And can the witnesses please come up to sign? During this time, we'll all join in singing Power of Your Love. Is it a rendition? No?
Lord, I come to
a special rendition, Power of Your Love.
Oh, me close
Let's all stand for the final commendation. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Joseph Symphorien. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
During the blessing, we will all join in singing, "My life is in your hands."
You don't have. Joy comes in the morning, troubled day don't last always. For there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, "Oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. With Jesus I can take it. With me
our response: receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to his aid, come to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ who called you take you to himself, may angels lead you to Abraham's side.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him forever.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Joseph Symphorien, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed through human weakness. In your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Joseph Symphorien, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Dear brothers and sisters, let's take our brother in peace to the place of his rest.
Remember to take everything you come here with, especially your cell phone, your bottle of water, your umbrella, etc. Father is going to lead the procession. Now, brothers and sisters, do not walk on the side. The side is not for us. The side is for people that is on their business. So Father is going to lead the procession along with the choir members and the family. Please sing along to continue with the celebration. As we take our brother's body to his final resting place, we will all join in singing, "It is well with my soul."
Let me walk upon.
my faith would be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me when my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith would be made stronger in the presence of my Savior.
Light his own candle, some other way. See now your sister, she's been robbed and lied to. Still holds a candle without a flame. So carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the lonely, the tired and
Hold on.
that second chance for a prayer that will make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh, beautiful release. Memories seep from my veins. Let me be empty. Oh, and weightless, and maybe you'll find some peace tonight in the arms of the angel. Fly away from here, from this dark, cold hotel room, and the endlessness that you feel.
himself, Symphorien, has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist him with our prayers. Let's also pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our brother, Joseph. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our brother Joseph Symphorien may sleep here in peace until you awaken him to glory. For you are the resurrection and the life, then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Joseph. Do not count his deeds against him, O Lord, for in his heart he desired to do your will. As his faith united him to your people on earth, so may your mercy join him to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. May the soul of Joseph and the souls of faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I know you're up in heaven, but damn, it hurts like hell. The facts, that won't bring you back, so I'll cry, 'cause it's over. Smile because we had you. Packed a whole lot of living, even though it ended all too soon. And in time, I'll start healing. But even when I get that feeling, no matter where I go or what I do, I'll never not remember you. Thank God for all the memories, pictures on my phone. They don't fill the empty, but I feel less alone. And I know you're with the angels, right where you belong. 'Cause you were one to us, you left a legacy of love. So I'll cry 'cause it's over, and smile because we had you. Packed a whole lot of living, even though it ended all too soon. And in time, I'll start healing. But even when I get that feeling, no matter where I go or what I do, I'll never not remember you. You lighten up a whole room like that. You made us think, made us feel, made us all laugh. You always giving that shirt off your back. I miss you bad, I miss you bad. So I'll cry 'cause it's over, smile because we had you. Packed a whole lot of living, even though it ended all too soon. And in time, I'll start healing. But even when I get that feeling, no matter where I go or what I do, I'll never not remember you. Oh, I promise you, I'll never not remember you. Thank you.
break these chains around me. I'm gonna learn to fly again. Maybe hard, but I'll do it. When I'm back on my feet again, soon these tears will all be drying. Soon these eyes will see the sun. Might take time, but I'll see it. When I'm back on my feet again, when I'm back on. And laughing, I'm gonna hear the voice of sin. Won't be long till I hear them. When I'm back on my feet again, I'm gonna feel the sweet light of heaven shining down. Light on me, one sweet day, I will feel it. When I'm back on my feet again, when I'm back.
If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your day's down here through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like.
Looking at photos and videos that we took, I've been keeping them for so long. And with my broken heart, I see all the pictures of myself living life without you, just feel so wrong. I want you to be here with me. I know it sounds crazy. I miss your laugh and I miss everything we used to be. And even if it is just for a while, then God, please give us the time. I can't deal with the reality. There's nothing left that I can do, 'cause my heart is just missing you. I tried everything, every way I could forget you, just so I can live my life without you. I want you to be here with me. I know it sounds crazy. I miss your laugh and I miss everything we used to be. And even if it is just for a while, then God, please give us the time. I can't deal with the reality. There's nothing left there I can't do, 'cause my heart is just missing you. Just missing you.
So fast,
I'm so numb, I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small. You were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, well, God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah.
Can bring a smile back to your face. Silent
Tell me, what does it look like in heaven? Is it peaceful? Is it free like they say? Does the sun shine bright forever? Have your fears and your pain gone away?
So nice up in heaven since.